brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines. I just made one video that the Lord asked me to make. I just got through praying, and the Lord led me to make a video about that we need to love our brothers and sisters in the Lord and show that now at this critical hour, so the world may know that we are followers of Christ, that the world may know that Jesus is the Christ, because we love the brethren. That's our sign from the church to the world, that Jesus is alive, that he resurrected, is that we love the brethren, our brothers and sisters in Christ. All right. I wanted to do a review. If you click under my video here, Near to Christ 2, I've got lots of different videos I made about the Antichrist. I even made one who I think he might be. Don't know for sure. Don't even know 10%. Just as what I've studied, what I've seen, a good guess. Don't know. Just did that. Some people had asked by request. Lots of videos. I want to run through some things, and I want to tell you, I asked you to Google these topics, okay? Because I can't really go into detail on them. Okay, here's the names, and I just wrote down a few of people that the Lord gave me their name, or the Lord led me to study them. There's a guy, Doc Marquis, M-A-R-Q-U-I-S, Marquis. He's a former Illuminati member who became a Christian back in the 70s. The Lord specifically led me to listen to his stuff, and that's been in the last week. Another guy, Tom Horn. I stumbled upon him as I was studying about the beast, the Antichrist being a fallen angel as a possibility. Apollyon. David Flynn. He's just died. He wrote two excellent books. You can listen to the interviews of these guys and videos by these guys on the internet if you don't have time to read the books. Okay, on the secular side, if you want to know how the New World Order is coming together, listen to Alex Jones. It's Infowars.com. If you can stand it, because all the news is negative and bad. It's the end of America as we know it. That's true. It's a Bible prophecy is being fulfilled. Just a few days ago, the Lord had given me Psalm 16. And that's quoted from Peter in Acts chapter 2 when he says, I saw the Lord always before me. And Peter quotes it in reference to the resurrection of the Christ. But the Lord gave me the original, text also. And Psalm 16 is also talking about resurrection. And, that the Lord will not leave any of us, his people, in Sheol or in the pit, but would deliver us into his kingdom. And so that Psalm 16 refers to resurrection. Now, we call it the rapture, but another name of what's going to happen at the rapture is a resurrection of those who are dead in Christ will come down with the Lord. They're already in heaven now in a spirit body. They will come down. Their bodies will come out of the ground or wherever they are, ashes or whatever they are. Their body will be restored just like Jesus when he was seen by his disciples. He was in a resurrected body. So those people who have died, who are in heaven now, are not in a resurrected body, but they will receive a resurrected body, immortality. They will take off their mortal body, put on immortality. So will we. Those of us who are alive and remain should be caught up with them to meet the Lord in the air. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, 18. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 51, 52. 50, 51, 52. It says we will not be the same. We'll change. We won't sleep. We won't die. We will change in a moment in the twinkling of an eye. We'll be caught up in the air and we'll put on our immortal, our perfect body. Just like Jesus went after the resurrection, he was in that perfect body. A body that can go through, go through the wall, but yet eat. Jesus walked through the wall and he ate, but then he ate. People were able to touch him, but yet he was able to disappear. He had like a higher dimensional body, as you could say scientifically. That's what we'll have. Like what the angels have, but even higher than that. The angels have some, there's one of these names people call the aliens. They'll say interdimensional beings. Well, those aliens are, demons or fallen angels. And they are interdimensional. They are at a higher dimension. As a matter of fact, they're at the fifth dimension, And I mentioned this in other videos. This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius. That song, the movie Hair, is all about Satan worship. Go look at all the songs from that. One of them is even about worshiping Lucifer and all kinds of crazy stuff from that movie, the play that became a movie, Hair. The name of the group that sings that song is the fifth dimension. Okay? And then if you look at a pentagram, I've made other videos about this, but inside the pentagram, which represents the goat head of Medes, or, Baphomet's head, inside the middle of that pentagram is you know, it's the five-pointed of a pentagon in the United States. And I'm going fast now. You can look this stuff up. Washington, D.C., we have the Pentagon there. Okay? It was built on July the 4th, 1941 or 42, whatever it was, 41 maybe. Anyway, that's the... Doesn't matter. It was on July the 4th, same as our country was founded on July the 4th, same day that the crash of the fallen angel scam, deception in Roswell was also on July the 4th. Okay, there's a Pentagon that they found just, you know, on Mars only like 10 or 20 years ago when the satellite went past there. So, and then that's the maxim that comes all the way back from the Emerald Tablet, all the way from the Tablet of Thoth, T-H-O-T-H, which is given credit to this Greek guy, Hermerides, from the Parthagian school, but it really came all the way back from the Egyptians, and really all the way back to Babylon. All this stuff from the devil originates really from, you know, the Babylon and Egypt. And the Lord had showed me that a long time ago. That's how I started studying about the Antichrist. The Lord took me all the way back to Akhenaten, you know, and then it just... All of these same old things, this modern-day New Age stuff and all of it, all of these lies from Satan go all the way back to, you know, to Nimrod and the Tower of Babel and all that. Came through Egypt, all these mystery schools, Masonry's a little part of it, and all of those things is all interconnected with the same old lies from the devil. So the maxim is as above is below. So when you see, this is something that the Lord just told me today, but I'd studied this over the last several days, like when they built Washington, D.C., and then they built the pyramids is a reflection of the Orion's belt. Okay, all these sacred sites all over the world, even down there in South America and the Mayans and all these different things, Aztecs, it's all a reflection of some things from stars. Okay, and that's their maxim of the devil, you know, as above it is below and all that. And this is, if you look at Baphomet, he's got that, you know, one on one arm and one written on the other, these Latin words, and it means, you know, you know the old alchemy they talk about, okay? It's really, and see, everything has a multiple interpretation, even in the Bible. But I'm going fast now. Follow me, those of you who know these things. Okay, the original thing of alchemy was to turn lead into gold, okay? But that's the superficial entry-level, initiate's understanding, the uninitiate's understanding. Okay, but what it really means, to turn lead into gold, this is what they really mean, this is what the devil means. You can become a god. You can go from a flesh to God. Whereas when we have the rapture, which I just talked about, God will transform us, okay, from an earthen fleshly vessel to a glorified body through Jesus Christ, through God, through the forgiveness of our sins and washing in the blood of the Lamb and all that. But then the devil's trying to tell people through magic, through Gnosticism, which means hidden wisdom, through all this hidden wisdom, the same wisdom that Adam and Eve got from eating that fruit. Which also, if you chop a golden apple in half along the equator, and look, you see there's a five-pointed goat's head right inside the seed pattern of that golden apple. It's a fact. Anyway, so they're trying to, you know, in other words, there was two trees in the garden. And I used to preach this sermon all the time before I knew all this stuff. The Lord had given me an evangelism sermon years ago when I first started coming to the Philippines, 2005, 2006. I started evangelizing, and I said there's two trees there in the same area. There's the garden of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, and then the tree of life. Why is it that Adam and Eve didn't eat from the tree of life? Instead, they chose to eat from knowledge. So it's like Jesus is like the tree of life. You know, if you eat from that fruit, from the tree of life, then there's eternal life. You know, but instead they try to take the back door away, the sneaky way that Satan led them, to try to steal God's wisdom through an unauthorized way. And anytime people do out-of-body experience, channeling, all that stuff, it's unauthorized access to the spirit world. And that's how you get in trouble. That's how the devil gets people. Unauthorized access to the power of God, trying to do magic, all this kind of stuff, alchemy, all these different sneaky ways. People are trying to get God's wisdom without going through God. That's what it boils down to. So I'm covering all this information fast. As I mentioned, as above, it's below. Okay? And so I just mentioned that how lead to gold really means to them, they're going to go from a human to a God. They're not going to become perfected as a Christian, as a human in the kingdom of God, but they will become a God themselves. That's what I mean by gold. They will become a God. Okay? Another thing is that God just, the Lord just shared this with me in my spirit today, that God told Moses, build the tabernacle in the wilderness after the pattern I showed you in heaven. Moses, when he was on the mountain, and he got the Ten Commandments, he was up there 40 days in the presence of God. And what he also got when he was there that people don't usually talk about, it's in the Bible. If you read your Bible, Exodus, you'll see that he got the wisdom on how to build the tabernacle in the wilderness and all that. The pattern after what the heaven is pattern. So as above in heaven is below is what Moses made from the third heaven. But these children of Satan and their God, Satan, they're trying to copy a pattern of the second heaven. See, it's a cheap imitation. So everything the Antichrist is going to do is going to be a cheap pattern of the Lord. Let me give you some more wisdom that the Lord gave me. For those of you who have an ear, who want to hear wisdom? About a year or two ago, the Lord asked me, what are those things that the Pharaoh is holding in his hand when you see the pictures? The Lord had me studying all about the different, about the Pharaoh and how he's a type of Antichrist. So what is the Pharaoh holding? He's holding a flagellated thing and a shepherd's rod. So then the Lord was showing me that he's a false shepherd. It's like he's shepherding the people. Jesus is the good shepherd. Okay, then he's holding this flagellated, like, you know, like a rod of iron. So he's trying to like, I'm going to, you know, the Antichrist, Satan thinks he's going to lead the people with a rod of iron. He's going to be the good shepherd. Do you see what I mean? Everything you want to know about the Antichrist, everything that Jesus did, he's going to try to mock that and copy that, a cheap imitation. Second heaven, as above, as below. The Lord is the third heaven, perfection. The real God of love and all that beauty, light and all that, the real deal, is what Moses received, okay? And then it was manifested as, you know, Jesus Christ came to earth. All right, let me keep going here. Okay, this yesterday or so, the Lord showed me a scepter, like a king scepter with a fleur-de-lis on top. If you watch my videos, I mentioned a lot, the Lord kept showing about fleur-de-lis. Okay, as a royal symbol of France, you know, and the Knights Templar and all this stuff. Anyway, the Lord led me to this tapestry. I found it. I Googled it, and there's a tapestry in a place called Anger, France. Okay, it's the Mosaic Apocalypse Mosaic, or the Mosaic of the Apocalypse. And in that, it's all about the France giving their power, and it's got like the dragon as England. France is like a ten-headed beast. You know, like from the Book of Revelation, France gives that scepter to England. It's supposed to represent that France is losing its authority or giving its authority to England. Okay, and then the Lord was just leading me in all of this, that the Knights Templar, as the Lord kept showing about the Knights Templar, okay, they're the ones who, you know, like I said, the Da Vinci Code stuff is all a lie, but it's somewhat truth, and this is the truth of it, that out of that Da Vinci Code, instead of getting a descendant of Jesus, you're going to get the Antichrist. All that stuff in the Da Vinci Code is leading and pointing to not the Christ, but the literal child of Jesus, but to the Antichrist. So the Knights Templar, the Lord's having me study all about that. I made videos about this. Okay, and I'm adding to that right now and reviewing. Okay, so the Knights Templar were ran out of France. And where did they go? They went up there to the United Kingdom. They went to Scotland. Up there, you got the Roslyn Chapel and all that. Okay, but in their beginning, it goes back to the Cathars and all that. Okay, back in southern France. That's your connection through France. And then about the same time that they, you know, killed Jacques d'Amelay and all those guys and took over the Knights Templar, the Knights Templar spread to Scotland, and it's about the same time that France really lost their power to England at that time. Okay? And so, see, you see the transfer of the Knights Templar. You see the transfer of their hidden wisdom and their worship of behalf of Samad to the United Kingdom. You see that royal authority going there. See, it's a linkage from the Middle East to the Mauregians, through France to England, still pointing toward the royal house of Windsor, still pointing to, you know, possibly Prince William as a good candidate to be the Antichrist, because his mother is Jewish, and you receive your race from your mother. He has a legitimate Jewish blood, and part of the title of his, when he becomes king, would be King of Jerusalem as part of his title. Good possibility. I don't know that for sure. The Lord didn't tell me that. I'm just speculating based on what the Lord told me. Okay, the Knights Templar, we talked about that. The Cathars, Roslyn's Chapel, Akhenaten. The Lord started me on all this quest of studying. I didn't have any desire to study about the Antichrist. The Lord started me about 2 or 3 years ago, showed me the Antichrist coming out of the Great Pyramid, and then he showed me Akhenaten and told me to study Akhenaten, a name that I couldn't even hardly pronounce. The Lord spoke it to me in my spirit while I was praying about 2 or 3 years ago. Okay, the Book of Enoch. Okay, the Book of Enoch is quoted throughout the Bible, especially in Jude. Some of the Book of Enoch was added later. That's why it's been kicked out of the Bible. As a matter of fact, they said that the Jewish people, the Jewish rabbis, kicked it out of their Bible about 200 or 300 AD. It was in our Bible for 700 or 800 years. They kicked it out because it was too much about the Son of Man, and they didn't like it because it seemed as if it was saying that Jesus was the Messiah. And anyway, parts of the Book of Enoch are claimed to be legitimate by experts in reading the ancient writing, archaic writing, that it's really very ancient writing, and some parts were added 200 or 300 BC. The copy was found in the Dead Sea Scrolls from about 200 or 300 BC. So we know it was before the time of Christ. Anyway, J.R. Church, you can look at his videos on the internet and see. The late J.R. Church, he did lots of shows and specials just covering the Book of Enoch, what parts they thought were real, what parts they thought were added. See that. It really has to do with the end times. Let's see. I just had a dream that I'll add this on here. I had a dream about MK Ultra. Okay, you can study that. Google it. And I was in Argentina. And there was Argentina Marines who were coming to the United States for assignment in the United States, something to do with the New World Order. And they had been tortured and programmed and brainwashed by American CIA MK Ultra. And I was interviewing them of what happened to them. They'd been tortured and all this stuff. But it had been erased from their memories. It was pretty wild, pretty wacky, something I would never think about. Makes me think that there's something truth to it. Let's see. Also, I mentioned in other videos that the Lord had shown me the spiral. It's the same thing. The spiral is a stargate. Same thing as your pentagon shape. That pentagon is a gateway, a stargate into the fifth dimension. That's where these demons come through. Fallen angels come through into our area. The Lord had also given me Moab, that there was a connection to the Antichrist of Moab. I also mentioned before that the Lord had spoken to me about the Heshemite kingdom connection, and that's connected before the Knights Templar. You know, the Knights Templar is connected to the Heshemite kingdom. One of King Solomon's wife was a Moabite, they said. And, you know, and King Solomon is supposed to be in the bloodline of Queen Elizabeth. So, Prince William. Okay, I had four dreams. I just mentioned this. Add this on. I'm trying to finish up the video. I had one dream. I had two dreams last July and then two dreams this July. As I made this little notes, which I usually don't. I made notes on my computer out of my prayer notes. And I was observing that I had four dreams. Two. One was on 7/21/11. And one was 7/22/11. Or, yeah, 7/22/11. And now I had one on 7/7/12 and one 7/11/12. So those are all kinds of wacky numbers. There's people that are into numbers, and that's some pretty wild. Anyway, first dream I had, and I didn't tell this dream last year because it's kind of disappointing to me and others. But in my dream, I was like on Noah's Ark. I was a leader of people getting on the Ark, and we were ready for the flood. The flood started, but it stopped. And then I was upset, and I was like, you know, Lord, I'm sorry. I told these people to get on the ark, and it's not the flood. And the Lord said, no, it's right. They need to be on the ark because the real flood's coming. And that was last July the 21st, 2011. I didn't make the video because I didn't know exactly how long it would be before the Lord would come, and I was kind of disappointed that it seems like there would be a delay. You know, last year there was lots of things going on that pointed to the return of the Lord. Okay, then I had another dream the next day on 7/22/11. There was lots of earthquakes. I made a video about this one. And there was a sudden tidal wave that swept everything away. Okay. Then, the 7/7 of this year, I was on a beach and there was waves that kept getting closer and closer, and I had to keep backing up to stay out of the waves. Okay. And then last night I had a dream, and there was a big, like a tidal wave, but it wasn't that bad. And this was like the first dream that I had about the Noah Ark. And then a giant one came, and that one was it. And the gap between the two was pretty close. Not long. And so I believe that the first wave is really what we've already experienced last year. There was lots of signs and wonders going on. The New Year's, birds dying, all that stuff that other people made videos about. It really seemed that it was going down last year. Tribulation was going to start. And that was just a small tidal wave. Now this is going to be it. I don't know when it will be. But, you know, I had four dreams really saying the same thing over his last year and this year. And that is that, you know, the big one's coming. And a tidal wave, and lots of people had dreams about tidal waves. Sometimes things are symbolic. And for me, it can be the glory of God, the judgment of God, or whatever. But for me, this is it. This is the judgment of God. The world's going to change. When a giant tidal wave would cover the whole earth, everything in its path has changed and destroyed and all that. Everything's completely changed. So this was not the glory of God. This was the judgment of God, the wrath of God. So it's coming. Tribulation, period. It's at hand. It's at hand, brothers and sisters. In this video, I covered lots of different things. There's tons of more things that the Lord showed me. Also, the Lord showed me Ace of Spades related to the Antichrist. I don't know what it means. I haven't had time to study that one. That was about 6 months ago. Washington Monument cracked. I wrote that down because if you read a book by Tom Horn, it's about the Apollyon Rising 2012 and all that. You can see, and there's other things you can study, that obelisk, okay, in the reflecting pool, as above is below. There's the obelisk reflecting in the water, okay. That's supposed to be about Osiris, and then the dome, in the Vatican's the same thing. The Vatican has the original obelisk from Heliopolis, City of the Sun, one of the names for the Antichrist. The phallic symbol in both places, with the dome in both places, represents, those two will come together symbolically or spiritually in the satanic mind of Horus and Isis and all that, and produce the Antichrist. So that all that information, like what Tom Horn's saying and those guys, is kind of pointing to the United States will be the one to produce the Antichrist. That's possible too. I have no idea. It could be a president of the United States. Could it be this president? Could be. It could be the next one. Whatever. I don't know. But anyway, I made video about, go back and look, I made a video of all the predictions, that's non-biblical predictions, that the Antichrist will come back, and the Antichrist will come to power in 2012. Seven different ones, I think, and actually there was eight, but here I got a ninth one I just thought about. I just remembered. I don't know why I remember these things. I guess the Lord put it in my mind. I only have to hear it one time and I remember. But I heard someone say that the Mormons have a prophecy. Here's another false religion prophecy, like the other eight predictions, not prophecies, I guess you call them predictions, in my other videos, besides the Mayans. But this one says that the Mormons believe that they will have a Mormon president during the time of the tribulation period. They believe they won't go in the rapture, which they won't, because they're not born again. That's why they want to have 7 years of food and all this, and they believe that they will have the president of the United States will be a Mormon, and he will lead the United States back to a right path during the time of the tribulation. Romney's running. Will Romney be the president? It's just a speculation. It's just a comment to throw out there, something that's been said. There's lots of things we can speculate on, brothers and sisters, and go on and on about it. It's a nice hobby because it keeps us, thinking about the Lord, and as things happen in the news, we can use it to evangelize and say, hey, the Mormons said that a Mormon will be president during the tribulation, and Romney just got elected, if that happens, if he were to get elected. That may lead to somebody getting saved. Whether it turns out that that false prediction of the Mormons turns out to be really happen or not, it could still be used for evangelism, brothers and sisters. That's why it's nice to know all these things, because this is what's happening in the news and what people can relate to. Okay, so God bless, and I'll see you soon in the air.